sure that the bonds and insurance requirements are met, get the contract signed as soon as possible.
When these two jobs are completed, there will be some 250,000 yards of concrete going into this expansion. And you know, we've moved well over 1 million yards of material on site to make way for these buildings.
Manafort Brothers provides the most comprehensive site development contracting services available in the region. Planning and critical path engineering ensures jobs are done right, on time, and within budget. Manafort's experience, extensive manpower, and dedicated equipment provides the one-source solution for your most challenging site development needs. With over 80 years of experience, we now offer contracting services for concrete, demolition, transportation, site development, and site remediation projects.
threw a massive pick of a 57-ton box and set it down in the hole. There's actually two boxes. They're gonna do two picks, and then they're gonna pick the lids and place the lids on top. Gets done and success.
Manafort Brothers Concrete Division is one of the largest in New England. The company's specialized equipment minimizes labor and maximizes production, which means jobs are poured safely and in record time. The fast-track construction of the new $1.2 billion Mohegan Sun Casino and Hotel Complex required the services of Manafort's expertise and experience in building cast-in-place, post-tension concrete superstructures. The concrete division supplied 150 men working two shifts, 6 days a week. They poured nearly 250,000 cubic yards of concrete. Manafort poured the concrete for the 7 parking garages, the 10,000-seat arena, and the foundation for the spectacular new casino with its unique attractions and new retail shops. Manafort uses the latest technology and forming systems when pouring concrete. The hotel superstructure, with its 1.2 million square feet of floor space, required the innovative use of roller decks and truss flyers to pour the slabs. Once in place, the reusable form allowed Manafort to spread 30,000 square feet of floor every 6 days. To accomplish this feat, a vertical pump line spanning over 400 feet was installed. Connected to a high-pressured trailer pump, the concrete was pushed through the line at 4,000 pounds per square inch. This allowed Manafort's crew to spread up to 60 yards of concrete per hour. The 37-story structure is 440 feet in height, the second tallest building in Connecticut. The Mohegan Sun Casino expansion and 1,200-room hotel stand majestically as a shining example of Manafort Brothers' experience, innovation, and equipment. The concrete division has expanded its services into the construction of design-built, precast parking garages. Due to its attractive integrated design, Manafort was awarded the construction of the 1,500-car parking garage and the new campus bookstore in the heart of the University of Connecticut's campus at Storrs. Manafort is now under contract to build the 1,250-car Stanford Transportation Center parking garage. The $25 million project of site work and concrete is being tightly constructed next to their existing garage. The 750-car garage on the campus of Eastern Connecticut State University, another design-built project, is further evidence of Manafort's growing success in the parking garage construction field. Whether your next project is a casino, a hotel, a football stadium, or a parking garage, Manafort's concrete division has the expertise, the manpower, and the equipment to deliver.
Manafort Brothers is the oldest demolition contractor in the Northeast. They have been demolition specialists for clients who are faced with critical deadlines and who own sites that contain hazardous materials. No job is too big or too hazardous. Manafort has the experience, the people, and the right equipment to complete any project on time and within budget. Whether the project is just an interior gutout for renovation or the removal of a city block in a tight urban center, let Manafort's expertise in comprehensive site remediation go to work for you. Manafort Brothers is highly responsive to any emergency situation. After the tragic events of 9/11, Manafort was one of the very few demolition contractors qualified to work at Ground Zero. Having vast experience in dismantling unstable structures, Manafort's men and heavy equipment went right to work to remove buildings number 4 and 5 of the World Trade Center. Working two 12-hour shifts, 7 days a week, the project was completed 2 weeks ahead of schedule.
Just finished the demolition plan at Main Yankee. We had our CAD department input all the coordinates for the turbine building. And we just finished our plan. They're going to submit it to the NRC.
Manafort Brothers is the first contractor to completely dismantle and decommission a commercial nuclear atomic energy plant. Manafort's men and extensive equipment have spent 6 months surgically removing the 4 million cubic foot turbine building. Every precaution is taken to ensure that the demolition is executed thoroughly and safely. Hundreds of miles of cables are stripped of their plastic coating that contain PCBs. Pulverized concrete containing low levels of radiation are loaded into boxcars and transported to EPA-certified landfills. All the material is monitored for radiation before it is trucked off the site. To knock down the massive three-story concrete pedestal that supported the turbine, Manafort used explosives to fracture the concrete. The strategically placed charges were detonated only 100 feet from the highly radioactive spent fuel pool. As Manafort's men and dedicated equipment steadily and professionally removed the contents of the turbine building, explosives were used again to bring down the steel skeleton that remained. With the demolition of the turbine building safely completed, the Manafort crew started the difficult work of removing the containment dome. The first challenge was the 700,000-pound polar crane that rotated at the very top of the dome. The safest, most effective way to remove the crane was to use explosives. Using torches, the men cut away at the huge crane to help weaken the structure. .42-inch shaped charges are carefully transported to the dome. For the massive polar crane to fall cleanly, the charges must be strategically placed. There is no room for error. Work continues into the night as the final preparations for the explosion are completed. A remote-controlled camera records the very first explosion ever to be detonated inside the containment dome of a nuclear power plant.
3, 2, 1, fire.
With the large polar crane resting safely at the bottom of the dome, Manafort's crew begins the work of cutting up the crane into smaller sections so that it can be removed from the area. Once the crane has been removed, the hoe ram takes aim at the 2.5-foot concrete wall that supported the crane. In addition to the demolition of the site, Manafort Brothers has also constructed the facility that will store the spent radioactive fuel once it is removed from the containment dome. Built to stringent NRC specifications, the spent fuel storage facility demonstrates Manafort's ability to handle any site, no matter how big or how technical it may be. When project deadlines become critical, explosives can be used to bring down the structure and reduce the time to complete the demolition. Imploding a building is a highly specialized field. For the building to come down accurately and safely, each phase of work must be carefully executed. Manafort has extensive experience and expertise in preparing buildings for implosions. And their track record for safety is unparalleled in the industry. We'll be right back.
Safety First is not just a slogan, it's a commitment. Our in-house safety department conducts regular training classes for all employees working in the field. We strive to exceed OSHA safety standards on all our jobs. Safety has become a culture at Manafort Brothers.
Like any industry, you have to have insurance, both workers' comp, general liability, and environmental insurance. And the price that you pay on insurance is based on your safety record. And here at Manafort Brothers, we've enjoyed an insurance safety record below average. And I'd like to see that continue in the next several years. It allows the company to be aggressive in bidding, and it allows it to provide its employees with benefits, incentive programs, proper training, the things that allow a company to succeed in today's environment.
Manafort Brothers has extensive experience in developing large, tough sites. During one project, they excavated and removed 400,000 cubic yards of earth in just 6 weeks. As part of its complete site development contracting services, Manafort Brothers owns and operates a comprehensive fleet of over 400 construction vehicles. They have their own maintenance department that repairs and fine-tunes the vehicles and equipment to keep them in top running order. With such a large fleet of trucks and specialized equipment, Manafort Brothers can respond to and complete large-scale projects within short time periods. We can handle any site development need: excavation, utility and pipeline installation, paving, drilling, sheeting, and soil stabilization. Here we see the beginning stages of a soil nail wall, an innovative use of concrete to stabilize and construct a 10,000 square foot retaining wall. As the embankment is excavated, Manafort's men install a wire mesh that is secured by steel rebar. Once in place, an operator sprays shotcrete along the face of the wall. As the concrete dries, more layers are sprayed. The white circular caps are sleeves where the nails will be inserted. Holes are drilled 30 to 40 feet into the embankment, and concrete grout is pumped in to stabilize the wall. As the weeks go by, each step of the process is repeated and the soil nail wall takes shape. Once the wall has been completely sprayed with shotcrete and stabilized with nails, an attractive facade is added. A thin layer of shotcrete is sprayed onto the face of the wall while men carefully hand-carve the outline of boulders before the concrete dries. A stain is applied, transforming the soil nail wall into a natural boulder scape. The soil nail wall is just another example of the innovative solutions Manafort can provide for your site development needs.
Jimmy, we've just been awarded the Connecticut DOT Project 109-154, which is the widening of I-84 in Plainville. We're adding a left lane from the New Britain town line all the way up to the Southington town line. It encompasses widening two bridges that are also in the area.
Manafort Brothers has expanded its site development services into the repair and construction of transportation infrastructures. They are currently widening a two-mile section of I-84 in Plainville, Connecticut. Soil and stone is being excavated and trucked away to make room for the construction of a new exit ramp. In Old Lyme, Connecticut, Manafort was responsible for all the highway construction for 1 mile on the eastern side of the new Baldwin Bridge. The project included an entrance ramp and exit ramp, construction of a new bridge, and paving the highway leading to the Baldwin Bridge. Manafort has been contracted by the state of Connecticut to repair the railroad bridges that serve Amtrak and Metro North rail lines. Equipment has been modified to ride along the tracks. Manafort can handle any transportation project, from pouring the concrete for a new airport terminal at Bradley International to the delicate construction of bridges in the most fragile of wetland areas. Manafort has the experience, the right equipment, and skilled people to get the job done right.
Today, the company is managed by the fourth generation of Manaforts, whose proactive management style has launched the company nationally to become one of the top 50 specialty contractors. Every bid is reviewed and signed off by a Manafort. They review job costs daily to ensure that the project budgets are monitored and every line item is accounted for. Their hands-on involvement with each project ensures that job-related issues are solved quickly and customer needs are continually met. Since 1919, Manafort Brothers has built a reputation founded on innovation, quality, safety, and client services. We strive to become the most complete contracting company in the region by providing our clients with unparalleled services and solutions for their site development challenges.
Thank you. Manafort Brothers is the first contractor to completely dismantle and decommission a commercial nuclear atomic energy plant. Currently, they are under contract with Maine Yankee in Wiscasset, Maine until 2005. Manafort's men and extensive equipment have spent 6 months surgically removing the 4 million cubic foot turbine building. Every precaution is taken to ensure that the demolition is executed thoroughly and safely. Hundreds of miles of cables are stripped of their plastic coating that contain PCBs. Pulverized concrete containing low levels of radiation are loaded into boxcars and transported to EPA-certified landfills. All the material is monitored for radiation before it is trucked off the site. To knock down the massive three-story concrete pedestal that supported the turbine, Manafort used explosives to fracture the concrete. The strategically placed charges were detonated only 100 feet from the highly radioactive spent fuel pool. As Manafort's men and dedicated equipment steadily and professionally removed the contents of the turbine building, explosives were used again to bring down the steel skeleton that remained.
We're a subcontractor to Manafort on this project. We're taking down part of the turbine bay. The turbine bay, we're standing on the south side of the bay right now. The reason that we aren't taking down the entire structure is on the north side, it abuts the control room for the whole facility. And they wanted a buffer zone in there. So actually, we're taking down about two-thirds of it. And this isn't going to be like the classic implosion where you see, you know, a structure come down and it's 10 feet tall. What we're trying to do, you can see behind me on the major columns, you can see the black areas. That's where we have explosives. What we're trying to do is get this down to an elevation that can be readily reached with their excavator and their shears. Right now we're on the southeast corner of the building. And what we want to do is start our explosive sequence on the northwest corner. And by doing that, if we knock out this column, we're putting an eccentric load on this truss. What's going to happen as it starts to fail, then we'll knock out this column. By eliminating the columns on the far side first, it will allow the building to swing, the trusses to swing in away from the building that's in the hot section. We're cutting each vertical member into pieces, so if it fell down, it is too short to reach the containment dome behind me. And you have spent fuel that's in there that is highly radioactive. Manafort has really gone overboard on, you know, looking at the safety aspects of this.
All right, here we go. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 3, 2, 1, fire.
Thank you.
nice thing about working with Manafort is they understand the business. I think they're really a company that does a marvelous professional job.
With the demolition of the turbine building safely completed, the Manafort crew started the difficult work of removing the containment dome. The first challenge was the 700,000-pound polar crane that rotated at the very top of the dome. The safest, most effective way to remove the crane was to use explosives. Using torches, the men cut away at the huge crane to help weaken the structure. .42-inch shaped charges are carefully transported to the dome. For the massive polar crane to fall cleanly, the charges must be strategically placed. There is no room for error. Work continues into the night as the final preparations for the explosion are completed. A remote-controlled camera records the very first explosion ever to be detonated inside the containment dome of a nuclear power plant.
3, 2, 1, fire.
With the large polar crane resting safely at the bottom of the dome, Manafort's crew begins the work of cutting up the crane into smaller sections so that it can be removed from the area. Once the crane has been removed, the hull ram takes aim at the 2.5-foot concrete wall that supported the crane. In addition to the demolition of the site, Manafort Brothers has also constructed the facility that will store the spent radioactive fuel once it is removed from the containment dome. Built to stringent NRC specifications, the spent fuel storage facility demonstrates Manafort's ability to handle any site, no matter how big or how technical it may be.
We've been here roughly about 5 years doing all the different stages of demolition here on site. Basically, the last thing that we're doing is taking down the containment dome. It's really the biggest and most difficult structure on site. Because of the height, you know, we really couldn't get up to the top and take it down conventionally the way we would a normal building, where you start at the top and you work it floor by floor and, you know, from the top down type operation. You know, we brought in controlled demolition, explosives expert.
You know, somebody said there's 20 million pounds of concrete left here. And if you use the ratio, we've used about 1,100 pounds. That's bringing a ton of concrete down for every pound of explosive, which is, and it just shows that, you know, gravity takes effect.
We don't think that the dome is going to break up once it hits the ground. I mean, it's so strong with the way the rebar is designed and the liner plate and all of that, I think it's going to come down to one piece.
A method that, you know, Justin came up with Maine Yankee was to create arches and leave the dome portion of the structure, which is a difficult part to break, leave it standing on columns that are approximately 85 feet tall. And a lot of engineering was done. Justin went out and bought this beautiful 750 high reach excavator with a hammer, and what they've done is systematically hammer out these slots. Manafort has wrapped the columns with fencing and fabric to keep any displaced material really from leaving the building's periphery. We're in a hot area now, radiologically controlled area. If any of the concrete comes out of that area into a clean area, then Maine Yankee has to go and survey all that concrete, and it, you know, albeit it's not going to cause any problem to the environment, it's just a bigger problem. We have 7 delays on each column. They're 9 milliseconds apart, and then the sequence is just going to work its way around, but it's going to be so fast, everything will be off within 3.5 seconds.
Five.
It's taken years to get approvals to do it. It's taken years of engineering. It's taken months by Manafort doing a great job to do the preparation for CDI to get to a point to start our drilling, to start our explosives loading. The whole goal of this is not to drop it like a regular implosion, but just kick the legs out to lower the dome. It's going to sit intact, to lower it down where it's readily reachable for his excavation equipment.